marriage or why they don't get married. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Of course, like I said, marriage is not compulsory. Marriage is not compulsory. Marriage is by choice. Marriage is by choice. And you don't have to be married to fulfill purpose in life. You don't have to be married to fulfill purpose in life. I want you to understand that marriage does not thrive on feelings and emotions. Marriage does not thrive on feelings and emotions. If you are in marriage, you have to understand the principles that guides marriage. Else, you will find yourself out of marriage. So what are the reasons why men are discouraged from getting married? Or why do we have divorces and separation all over? I have mentioned some points, and I will continue from where I stop. Tonight, I'm going to start with fashion consciousness. High fashion consciousness. Everyone wants to look good. Everyone wants to be accepted via fashion. But doing it in a way, or running it in a way that affects your partner, can lead your marriage to a crash. And some ladies, the reason why they are not married is simply based on fashion. They want to be current with every designers in town, and that has led many to problems in marriage, or has led many, was not allowed many to get married. Number 9, I guess, job startups is another major problem why many are not married, or why we have divorces and separation. Some people are not ready in any way to let down their guards for their husbands or for their wives when it comes to their job status, especially the career women. Some of them respect their bosses, but they don't respect their men. Probably because their bosses pay their salaries, and the man doesn't pay salaries. Probably the man doesn't really have much. Or if the lady earns more than her husband, this can lead to a problem in marriage. And that's one of the reasons why many men are running away from most of our ladies who are career driven. Number 10. Wrong mindset is another major challenge. Wrong mindset is the reason why so many are not married. Their minds are porous, their minds have been polluted, probably via their culture or tradition or beliefs. So many of them have gotten wrong information, and as a result of this, are not married, or have found themselves in marriage and at the same time out of marriage. Why? Well, because of wrong mindset, wrong information. When we were born, some of us, our parents, told us that when a man does this, the best thing is to leave him. Or when a woman does this, the best thing is to pick another woman. I have seen it most especially in my culture, that when there is delay in pregnancy or in childbearing, you will begin to see or you begin to hear a lot of information coming from everywhere. The reason why she was barren, probably she had messed up when she was not married, or her womb was removed, and this and that has led to many marriages ending in divorce, and of course, many ladies are yet not married. Number 12. Is it number 11?
Yes.
Okay. Social conformity. Social conformity. Many of us, of course, know what social life means. I have seen some people, you know. In fact, it's fast killing marriages now. Your husband is talking and the wife is thinking. The wife is always on the phone. Whilst the husband is talking, the wife is speaking, or the wife is talking, the husband is speaking. There was a time like that I was talking to my wife, and then she was using me to ping to whatever she was doing on her phone. In fact, I felt like, you know, collecting that phone and smashing the phone to the wall. But thank God for grace of patience. So I just left the scene because I don't want to cause unnecessary wahala. So many of us want to conform with social world, what is happening around. You know, you want to be on Instagram, you want to be on Facebook, and some men don't like it. Some men don't like it. You understand? You just want to show up like what we see all around today, that some of our ladies are displaying. You can imagine a married man, or sorry, a married woman, you know, showing all, you know, endowment on social media, and you know, putting all our lives on social media. So these are some of the problems why some men don't get married, and then why some women are yet not married. You know, for example, with what I see on the social media, I'm very sorry if I'm still single and I want to marry now, I will not marry anybody from there, because everything that I'm supposed to see alone has been displayed on social media, because you want to conform to what is happening in the world. Now, let me speak on why you can't blame God for your divorce or for your separation, or why you are not married. Why you can't blame God, or why God will be justified. Before I start that, let me quickly speak on this number 12. Why men are not married, and why women are not married, or why we have so many divorces and separation. Number 12, pastors. Misleading of pastors. So many pastors have misled some ladies, because especially when it comes to prayer, spirituality. Go and pray about this. Once a woman came to me some years back and brought five names to me and said, "Pastor, please, which one is the right man for my daughter?" And I looked at those names. I said, "I don't know. Honestly, I don't know." Yes, they want you to use your spiritual power or your spiritual sensitivity, probably discerning spirit, to discern which is the best. And the woman came to me. The first question I asked her was, "How old is your daughter?" And she said, "She's 19 years. And then you brought me five names of grown-up men for a 19-year-old girl. I said, "Mommy, why don't you send this girl back to school?" She said, "No, because she's, you know, she's growing faster, and I quickly want her to get married." I said, "Well, I don't pray on names." Some pastors have misled so many people, you understand, have turned them to prayer slaves by encouraging them to bring the name of one brother or the other, or one sister or the other, so that they can choose for them. You don't choose for anybody when it comes to marriage. I understand some that there are three things you don't deprive or you don't deny a child from having. Number one, you don't tell a child not to buy a car, you don't tell a child not to get married, and you don't tell a child not to build a house. Because as at the time the money was available that he or she wants to build or get married or buy a car, and you discourage that child. When the time comes and he's not able or she's not able to meet up with such target anymore, who do you think the child will blame? Pastor or the parent? That's why when it comes to marriage, you don't stop anybody from getting married. It's based on their choices. You just have to encourage them and make them see why they shouldn't do it now. And if they say, no, Pastor, we are going on, just allow it be. Let them go. Join them in holy matrimony and wish them well. And the Lord will help them. In Jesus' name. So I don't discourage people from getting married. Even if you bring a two-headed man and you say, Pastor, this is the man that God has chosen for me, I will only ask you, are you sure? Are you in love with this man? Are you sure this is the man you want to live the rest of your life with? Yes. You know, at that stage, I have seen so many who are emotional and who are allow their feelings to run over the reality of the Word of God in their lives and say, he's the one. God gave me this confirmation. We are always bringing God into the picture. There was one wedding that I was to conduct several years ago. The lady came to me and said, Pastor, finally, the lady was my daughter in those days. And she came to me and said, Pastor, finally God had answered my prayers. I said, beautiful, please bring the guy to me. And she brought the guy. Very handsome, good-looking guy. But I just don't know why. I just don't know why I felt strange about both of them coming together. I said, lady, do you know, as you are my daughter, I don't think you should go into this marriage. Ah, Pastor, you don't understand. I said, okay, how do you know that this is the real guy for you? He said, in the banking hall. As I was in the banking hall, somebody just touched me and said, you are getting married this year. And whether in the market or wherever, somebody said, you are getting married. I said, well, that's the reason why you want to marry by force by two last this year. She said, Pastor, God has spoken. And I have always understood that once have I spoken, and twice have I heard that all power belongs to God. So the guy came to me, oh, he seems like a nice guy that I like. And I called the guy as man to man. I said, I don't think you should go into this marriage. The guy gave me all the reason why you should go into the marriage. I said, well, time will tell. I just believe because God loves the both of them and he didn't want them to go akabako in the marriage. You understand? The guy, the first thing that happened was that he sold his car, you know, to pay for a house. And the house, he couldn't complete the balance of the house. And it was going back and forth, back and forth. I said, you guys, these are signs that you shouldn't come together. But they didn't agree with me. On the day of marriage, they had printed the invitation, they had got assurance, they had done everything necessary, everything possible for the marriage to come to reality. Only for the lady to fall sick, and she was admitted on the day of marriage. And the husband drank again. Praise the Lord. Later, several years ago, the guy called me back and started thanking me. And I give God all the glory. So pastors have misled so many people. Pastors are one of the major problems why some ladies are yet not married today. If your pastor have a crush on you, you are in trouble. Because you can't get married. The pastor will always give you reason why you should not get married until your time will pass. Until your time will pass. And I have seen it happen in some churches that some pastors, because the lady is single and she's active in the church, she's bringing in big tithes, she's giving pastor support and everything. So when any guy comes, the pastor will discourage the marriage from happening. So a lot of that is happening even in the body of Christ. So pastors are one major problem that we have, discouraging people from getting married. or the ones who are married, pastors, are equally involved in some of these divorces that we see all over, keeping the wives, you know, of some men in church for long. What are you doing with them? You know, because there's a song we used to sing in those days that when Jesus Christ resurrected, the first set of human beings that saw him were the women. So we have the church populated with young ladies, young women, and stuff like that. So pastors, you know, sometimes have those problems of releasing them, or sometimes giving them false prophecies. You know, ladies are vulnerable. I've seen it where I was before. When they give them prophecies, they're always jumping at prophecies and so many other things like that. And that has led many to divorces, and many are still single. Then number 13, over-spirituality. Over-spirituality is another major problem. Some of our ladies have become unnecessarily spiritual, that they are even spiritual than God. They are even more spiritual than God. You know, your husband meets you by his side, you are fasting and you are praying. The fasting and prayers that your husband has not approved, and suddenly you believe that there is a problem somewhere and you need to fast. And the husband is not fasting, waiting on the side of the bed to do some worship. Praise the Lord. To do some praise the Lord. And then I see what is happening around now. Many of our ladies or many of our married women are on one group of prayers or the other group of prayers. Please calm it down. Calm it down. Don't just wound yourself, kill your marriage, or kill your singleness. Be careful. Be careful, be careful. Many of us don't know that, most especially in marriage, the ultimate thing that you need to work on is your character, not prayers. It's your character. It's your character that people will see. The Bible says, by their fruit, you shall know them. I'm expecting people to work more on the fruit of the Spirit. On the fruit of the Spirit. Not fasting and prayers. Not fasting and prayers. Some people will go to Kekoi. Some people will go to Kilimanjaro. What were they looking for? Pastor, please confirm to me. Is he my husband? Is he my wife? On the mountain? On the mountain, I am sorry to say, if you are climbing mountain to go and pray, you are a basic human being. And you don't have focus. You don't even have vision. You don't even have direction. Why should you be praying for a man that is meant to be searching for you? Why should you be fasting for a man that should look for you? The power to tame a man has been given to the woman or to the women. The Bible says, he who finds a wife, he who searches for a wife, will find a good thing, and that good thing will become favor. Will become favor, or will attract favor from God. Ladies are meant to sleep at home or stay at home with their fathers. You are not supposed to be anxious. You are not supposed to be looking at the window whether the guy will come. I remember in the olden days, you know, the way marriages were conducted then, I still believe, and I'm praying that God should bring the same method back to this present day and age. When a man finds a woman, the first thing you do is to go and tell your parents. Is to go and tell your parents, not to go and tell the lady. Amen? Though it looks somehow today. Amen? Because social media, Facebook is Facebooking everybody. You understand? The first thing you need to do is to go and tell your parents, and your parents will now go to the family of that lady. They will research about the family of that lady. Of course, my mother-in-law did the same to me. She went to my village to find out everything about my family. What is this family about? What do they believe in? Who is this person? Who is the man there? Who is the head of this family? The man went in search for every information until she got what she wanted. That was when she allowed her daughter to marry me. No sentiment, no emotion, no feelings at all. But so many of us today We don't even allow our parents. We don't allow their voices anymore. Because you believe you know, because you believe you understand. You have now suddenly become spiritual over, you know, everything more than your parents, even more than God. Spirituality is another problem. Why so many ladies are still waiting, and why so many men or women are out of marriage? Spirituality. Every time the woman is in church, what are you doing? Praying. What are you praying about? One deliverance service to another deliverance service. One church program to another church program. And your husband is sitting at home hungry. And you are everywhere praying. What are you praying for? You don't know that you have to plan what your husband will eat, what your children will eat. You are going everywhere praying. You are always on your mobile phone. You are joining one group or the other, praying. What are they praying about? What are they praying about? That is where God should start. And I pray that God will deliver us. I don't belong to any prayer group. I don't belong to any prayer group, and I don't have to belong to any. I don't have to belong to any prayer group, because prayer group will not help my marriage. It will not help my marriage. It's not the prayer that you want to pray in the prayer group that will make my marriage work. Who is counseling me? I don't even know you. Who is leading the prayer point? I don't even know what you are going through. I don't even know who you are. And he's the one leading you. She's the one leading you. And you are praying as if you will die here. And your husband is starving. He wants you in bed. He wants you by his side so that both of you can worship in spirit and in truth. And it's prayer all the way. So I'm going to give you some points why God will be justified. Why you can't blame God when your marriage fails or when you are not married. I've told you it's by choice. If you are single, it's by choice that you are single. It's not as if it is God that gets you single. It is by choice that you are single. So number one, marriage is by your choice. Number two, marriage is not on God's demand. It is on your demand. Number three, God cannot be blamed for marital default or for singleness. God cannot be blamed for marital default or singleness. God did not break your marriage, please. God did not break my marriage. If I want to put an end to my marriage today, it's not God, it is me. I am the God that has stopped it. I am the God that has parted the Red Sea. It is me that will say, hey, I don't want you anymore. If I were to go by God's standard, God will say forgive her. Or God will say forgiving, irrespective of whatever he has done. And I want us to know that it is only in Christianity that we divorce and separate. It is only in Christianity that we divorce and separate. And I want you to know that it wasn't God who named us Christians. That name came from the world, from the heathen, from the Gentiles. When they saw the disciples in Antioch, that was when the name came forth. That was when they were named Christians. So God did not name us Christians. We are his ambassadors. 1 Peter 2:9, you are a chosen generation. You are a royal priesthood. You are peculiar people. You are called out of darkness into his marvelous light. We are God's representatives here and now. We are God's ambassadors here and now. So if I were to name us tonight, I would say you are a kingdom citizen. And in the kingdom of God, there is nothing like divorce. God said, I hate divorce. I hate divorce. And in the kingdom of God, there is forgiveness. Complete and absolute forgiveness. Jesus Christ was talking to Peter. Peter came and said, how many times do you think we should forgive? Jesus said to him, 70 times a day. Multiply 70 by 70, or 7 by 70, per day. And I'm not sure there is anyone who can exhaust that number. You cannot. So in the kingdom of God, it is forgiveness. The Bible says, if you don't forgive, your heavenly Father will not forgive you. I have seen so many people who have divorced their wives and their husbands and whatever is happening to them, and they are laying the blame on God, or they are trying to make it a Christian thing that it is acceptable in the kingdom of God. Hey, I beg to differ. God hates divorce. And the Bible says, my words are yea and amen. Not even a jot of my word will go unfulfilled. And as God has spoken, it is settled. Forever, O Lord, thy word is settled. If you are not married, it is either you made the wrong choice or you have violated marital principles. If you are not married, it's either you have made the wrong choice in life or you have violated marital principles. Some of us, whilst we are single, we have made wrong choices of guys. When you saw this one, he's the one. Another one, he's the one. I've been okay, he's the one. This one, orange man came, he's the one. This one, that one, this one, that one, this one. You are not confused. I have seen some ladies dating five guys, and you are saying God should choose from them. God is not an author of confusion. He's not an author of confusion. I have seen in one church, three guys were receiving vision for one lady. And everybody is still saying it is God. I remember one in those days, this one and this, my friend. The ladies in the church, there were three of them, they were answering to Ronke. So he said God told him, God gave him a name. And that same God forgot to give him Sonny. Praise God. God only gave him the first name, the surname was missing. So the first name that God gave to him was Ronke. So he went to the first Ronke, that was said, I am engaged. He left that one, he went to the second Ronke, that was said, surely a pleasure. And from there, he went to the third Ronke, who was desperately looking for a guy. And that Ronke accepted the offer and made my brother a driver. Collected his first car and made him a driver. Collected his business and became the boss of the business. And the day we were in church, somebody just came and gave us one information that, what are you doing here? Your wife to be is getting married in the other church there. He has used my brother to step up. Like when we had, he was actually the one that provoked me to marry, because anytime around him, he said, what are you doing here? Bloody single, get away. Bloody single. The lady will bring food. The guy was just eating. He will bring plantain, he will bring big fish, he will bring yam and beans, yam and egg. My brother was just eating. Anytime I beg, I said, I give this mother. He said, he's for married men. He's for married men. Until that day, that the lady was getting married in all same church. And we were standing, playing, expecting her to come. And we were told she was getting married in the other church. May God deliver all of us from this spirituality in the mighty name of Jesus. So your choices can affect you. I know some of you are waiting on the Lord seriously, most especially our single ladies. You are waiting on the Lord. You are waiting on the Lord that God will speak. God will send me the right man. God will never send you any man. God will never send you any man. The reason why you were created in the image and the likeness of God, number one, is for you to be able to reason and make the right choices. Because God has given you the free will power. He has given you the free will power. And so many have violated marital principles. When you were told to wait, you were jumping. Some of us, as we are moving from one guy to the other, probably in line of that, there is pregnancy. And the guy abandoned you and says, I'm not prepared for this. And he left you. So I have seen many single mothers who still believe in God, that God will show them favor. Amen? But we are praying every day that God will help them in Jesus' name. Marriage is not a do or die affair. It's not a do or die affair. Please don't get married so that, you get married and the devil catches up with you. It is over. We can't save you again. Don't get married to make yourself go through trauma that will destroy you. So many have gotten married and the marriage have ended their lives. So many have died because of desperation to get married. Only for them to get into the institution and they discover that it wasn't what they bargained for. So it's not a do or die affair. You don't have to be married to be happy or fulfilled. Find your purpose. Your purpose will give you fulfillment. Your purpose will give you happiness. Your purpose will give you joy. A life without purpose is a miserable life. When the purpose of a thing is not known, abuse is inevitable. When the purpose of a thing is not known, abuse is inevitable. So you don't have to be married to fulfill purpose. Find your purpose first. As a single lady, find your purpose first. Find your assignment first. Run with it and make sure something is established. I've often been saying this. A lazy lady will meet a lazy man. Peradventure, if you meet a man that is hardworking, it's just a matter of time. He will spill you out. When you are lazy, marriage will expose you. When you are full of bad habits, marriage will expose you. You see, one thing about marriage is that marriage doesn't keep anything. It exposes. It's like a scanning machine. It's like an X-ray machine. You know, nobody can see you whilst you are single, but marriage will X-ray you. Marriage will reveal your true nature and your true character. So you don't have to be married to fulfill, to be happy or to be fulfilled. Your separation or divorce is by choice. It's by choice, not from God's demand. Your separation or divorce is by choice. If I don't love my wife anymore, it is my choice to let her go. Praise God. I said if. I'm not saying I don't love her. If I don't love her anymore, it is my choice to let her go. I have seen marriages of 21 years ended in divorce. I have seen of 20-something years ended in divorce. I have seen of 15 years ended in divorce. Why? It usually started on love. Why divorce? It usually started on love. I see, these days, just come and say, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. And 2 months later, say, I'm not interested. If you go to Ikoyi here, where they are joining people every day, you will discover that as they are joining them every day, they are starting them every day. Joining every day, starting every day. Some have said, the Spirit said you are my wife, only for them to discover that it wasn't the Spirit. It was their feelings or emotion. And feelings disappeared. And he said, no, the Spirit has not spoken. And then some, he said, Spirit is saying you are not the one, he's that one. So many terrible things happening, and we are always bringing God in. So your divorce or separation is by choice. It's by choice. And most often, this comes when characters are being revealed. This comes when characters and habits are being revealed. There are some ladies, they don't just want to change. They are heady, they are stubborn. There are some guys, they are stubborn, they are heady. They don't just want to change. And the only thing that is constant in life is what? Change. It is only God that will not change. So when you marry a guy today, please, just bear it at the back of your mind that that guy will change. That lady will change. I remember one time, I told my wife, I said, do you know I've not been married before? Because if I've done it before, probably I will know how to do it best. But I've not done it before. It's a new journey for me. It's a new adventure. I am learning every day in marriage. I am learning every day in marriage. You have to put up with different character, different nature, and so many other things that you will begin to see. And for me, it's for your growth. It's not for you to pick offense or get angry unnecessarily, because when you allow anger to come in, the devil can use that avenue to scatter everything, and it will eventually end in divorce. It may end in separation as well. I believe I've told you the story of a young lady who called me and said she was tired of the marriage and she was looking for another man to sleep with. And I told her, I said, why? She said, I'm just tired of that man. The man doesn't care. It is now he doesn't care. He doesn't give me attention. All ladies want attention. Selfish set of human beings. If you like, see anything, they are selfish. I'm telling you the truth. They are selfish. 80%, I stand to say it here on the altar, 80% of our babies are selfish. It's all about me, and me. Are you me noodles? Praise the Lord. Eh? You are not romantic. Buy me this. Hey, take me out. And I want to eat chicken. They said it's their nature. You can imagine what a rubbish nature is. What is our own nature? Praise God. No, in all honesty, these are some of the things driving guys crazy. These are some of the things driving guys crazy. In all honesty, most of our ladies are not patient. Marriage is not automatic. It will not happen overnight. It is a journey to a success. The guy may not be able to do those things today, and 15 years down the line, he may buy you the car that you don't even expect in your life. Somebody once asked me, I once asked a question. I said, what exactly is romance? I said, you buy flowers, you buy gifts, you make your wife happy. I said, well, how about me? Who will buy flower for me? Who will buy me roses? Praise the Lord. Does that mean men are bone to bone? He said, ladies are soft. They must be treated this way. They must be treated that way. And these are some of the things that is sinking our marriages. Unnecessary attention. Marriage is growing. You have to grow it. It's growth. And there must be sacrifice involved in growing a marriage. And it is expected for both parties to grow the marriage together. There are things that I couldn't do 10 years ago that I can do now. There were things that I couldn't do 15 years ago that I can do now. So it's not automatic. You just got married yesterday. You are demanding so much from the guy. Take me out. On Valentine's Day, where are we going? You don't even know. You don't even know whether the guy has something in his pocket. You don't even know what the guy is going through. You don't even know how the guy is thinking of how to manage, how to sustain. And there is Valentine. What are you buying for me? On the Valentine's Day, are you taking, where are we going to? Some ladies will be saying double for 4 points. You will be measuring your courage. God, we are. And if it's a guy who cannot manage your taste, what do you expect? And if you don't meet up with that target, I have discovered that the ladies will not begin to pick those things. They will not begin to use it to talk to their men. Is this how other men behave? They will not begin to do comparison. I know my friend, the husband took her to Dubai, and so, if I can't take you to Dubai, at least I have taken you to my room. It's a journey. When the money comes, I will take you beyond Dubai. You will even go to Sahara Desert. To go and pack the sand there. So that you can know that, hey, I have gotten to Sahara Desert. I will take you to Israel. Where Jesus was buried. And by the grace of God, I will ensure that you do your second baptism in River Jordan. Unnecessary demands. So whenever marriage is breaks in divorce or separation, it is not God. It is choice. It is choice. Some of our ladies, they don't forgive. Neither will they forget. Somebody was saying that I did something several years ago and she picked a book to be writing my wrongs. You can imagine. If I had gotten married before, it's a different thing. You can do that perfectly. But thank God for Holy Spirit that spoke. Because if I discovered that group, then imagine. If I had seen that group, me too, I would go and pick another band. And I would begin to monitor and begin to right wrongs every time. These are some of the things that we are doing that usually ends marriage, a divorce, a separation. And that's why some ladies are not my taste. The guy that will marry me must take me to Dubai, must take me to London. We want to shop. We must go and shop in Switzerland. And then, and you are now looking everywhere for the guy that carries London on his shoulder. And God help you. You are living on Agugi Road. And the ones that you see here, on their shoulder was written Osama, 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 Osama. Praise God. So divorces and separation is not of God. Your marriage will reflect who you are. Your marriage reflects who you are. You can't hide it. Your marriage reflects who you are. Marriage, in a way, has helped me to know that, number one, I am temperamental. It has helped me to know that I am not patient enough. It has so many things that marriage had opened my eyes to. When I was single, I saw those as my strength. I saw those as my energy. And some people are still holding on to those things, using them to spite one another. I saw every reason why I have to be patient, why I have to be long-suffering, why I have to persevere. I saw every reason why. And it's not because I love my wife. It's not. It's not because I love my wife. If it were to be love, it's long gone. It's not. It's because I have a destination. So when you know you have a destination, it will provoke your love continuously. When you know there is a destination that God has assigned you to get to, you will do everything possible to get to that expected end, because God has gone ahead of you to prepare a beautiful future. And listen to me, you must get there. You know, God is not emotional, and he's not a God that runs by feelings. His words are yea and amen. And as he has said it, it must be done. If you violate or go contrary to his word, it's disobedience. So God has taken that time to prepare you an expected end. Jeremiah 29:11. He has gone ahead to prepare that expected end. Listen to me. If you don't get to that destination, you are a failure. You are a failure. If I ask you to go to Ibadan, I have gone to Ibadan to build a house there, a mansion there at Ibadan. And I came back to Lagos to say, Mr. Ike, this is the key to the house in Ibadan. And you go to the electoral camp and return. You are failed. You are failed. Walk out your marriage with fear and trembling. Not only your salvation, your marriage with fear and trembling. Sometimes I look at myself, I say, Tunde Omatiya Mumu. Yes. I look at myself. Certain things that I will never take in my life. I will never take it. But look at what marriage has turned me to. I became humble that I will even see some things and I'll be laughing. When I was single, you dare not try such with me. Suddenly I discovered that marriage has made me that open that I have to be taking pain for some people. I have to be taking pains. It's not because of marriage, it's because of the purpose that God has given to me that founded my marriage. So when your marriage ends in divorce or separation, it's because you have not found your purpose. Irrespective of excuse that you have not found that purpose. I have seen many people separated and divorced. They are top of tea. I don't have answers to that. It's only God that can answer that. It's only God Almighty that can answer that question. All I know is that God hates divorce and we stand on the truth of the word of God. So you have to fight a good fight of faith to ensure that your marriage works. And not because of your partner, but because of the destination that God has prepared for you. God has prepared for you. And that will humble you, that will break you, that will make you look like fools sometimes. You know, sometimes you just, when you are reading the Bible, look at Jesus Christ in Philippians 2. Let's look at Philippians 2. Let's read Philippians 2 from verse 5. Philippians 2 from verse 5. You can imagine Jesus Christ, the Son of God, because he has a purpose. Philippians 2 said, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, verse 6. He said, who being in the form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God. 7. He says, but made himself of no reputation. He made himself of no reputation. That's the situation I find myself now. Made himself of no reputation, taking the form of a bond servant and coming in the likeness of men. That's Jesus Christ, the Savior of mankind. The one who came to die for you and I. And being found in the appearance of as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even the death of the cross. Why? Let's look at Hebrews 2. I want you to see why he did this. Hebrews 2. Hebrews 12, 2b. That's Hebrews 12, 2. Looking unto who? He said, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Now he's saying, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him. What did he do? Despising shame. Endure. Do you know what is called endure? Endurance. When is good, when is bad, continue to do what? That's the state I found myself in now. Just have to continue to endure. Some people say, only okay. You look at the person and say, which of the end? You say it's your own. You say I'm enjoying it. You know, some people, it's not as if they will tell you only okay, but indirectly they will tell you your head is not correct because the way they behave around you, they think your head is not correct. Taking you for granted. You can imagine. Some people will just, that you are trying to correct, they will not greet you. And I will walk past and I will laugh. And I will look at, I say, Lord, say, shut up, go. Because I must get to the finishing line. I must get to the finishing line. I see a whole lot of things. You greet this one, they will not understand you. You even greet somebody that you are helping. And he's telling you that, what nonsense. Ah! I say, no, what? And you can't do anything. And you want to do something and you are hearing, leaving. Leaving. Because you just have to be focused to get to the finishing line. If not, no celebration. And I can't imagine a lady divorced this one, got married to this one, got to this place, discovered that this one is not compatible, divorced him again, moved to the third well, move to the fourth one. I have seen some women giving birth to four different men. What are they looking for? Is that how body pinches them? Four different men. Thank you. I've seen that some men is jumping from one man to another, sleeping around. But God will have mercy on us. Your marriage reflects your character, and it is your character that will determine how your marriage will end, whether good or bad. Your marriage or your singleness will equally reflect your character, and it is your character that will determine whether you will get married or you will remain single for the rest of your days on the planet Earth. And of course, the church is looking for bishops and monks, so you can apply. Prayer and fasting does not make marriage work when you have the default character. That's what I see everywhere. Some people are hiding behind prayers and hiding behind fasting. Sometimes I just look at it and say, what nonsense is this? Like some of our ladies, you don't know how to cook. And you are praying and fasting. Instead of you to go and learn how to do it, Holy Spirit will come and teach you, Shay. You don't know how to cook. Some don't even have adventure. They don't even. Some is just three types of food. They know how to cook every day, every year. If it's not rice, it is Indomie. It's not Indomie. It is yam. Simple. Morning, night, afternoon. Yam in the morning, they mix it with egg. In the afternoon, with garden egg and yellow oil. And at night, it's eba, everything. Praise God. It's only God that has given me grace. If not, if my head were to be a farmland, you would have seen different ever everywhere. Praise God. Change your character. Work on yourself. Stop dwelling in the past. Stop glorying in your past character. This is who I am. And so what? Change. We are in 2019. Build up yourself. Work on yourself, like I said. Develop yourself on a daily basis. And don't hide behind spirit. God is a spirit. He lives in heaven. Even God, as is a spirit, cannot interfere in our affairs here unless we invite him in. If you don't invite him in, he doesn't have power to do anything here. So he has made us in his image and after his likeness to dominate this earth. We are now spiritualizing everything. I'm not saying you are not a spirit. You are spirit. But there are certain things, most especially in marriage, that requires practicality. Just do it. Some of us don't know how to greet. You were not brought up with that manner. You don't know how to greet. And now you don't greet your husband. Someone to greet the new home.
It's
me, homeward. God, you have mercy on me. So it's not prayers. Like I said, some of you are doing some unnecessary prayers that God will never answer. I'm sorry to say. Unnecessary prayers. Hiding behind it. God is saying, I gave you that man, manage him. I gave you that woman, manage her. Don't pray. Manage her. Manage him. Study him. Learn of him. Work with him. Treat him well. Treat her well. Sometimes when I'm reading the Bible, why won't God parley with Abraham? Because Sarah honored that man. And the only thing the Bible says in Ephesians 5 to women is that honor is an access key. As I am standing here, if you don't honor me, you can't connect. It does not matter how far you pray or fast. Because God had made the man the head of the family. After God is man. The man is connected to God. You don't want to bypass to meet God. God has hierarchy and he cannot violate it for anybody irrespective of who you are. He says, honor your husband. And the husband should love their wives. And when I was reading that scripture, honor and love. Which comes first? Which one comes first? Church, please help me. Which one comes first? Which one comes first? If you honor your husband, love will come automatically. That's why our parents in those days, see honor. My love. Ah, your father was the one that killed 5 lions in the jungle of Amazon. Boko Haram killing everybody. The day your father appeared, he captured every one of them. The man will suddenly. How do you know? The weapon we were using in those days. The man. What do you want? Say, my love. It's not what I want. It's not what I don't want. I just want you to know that. In fact, God is this. You are this. You say, okay. I used to see how my mom, whenever she wants to collect something from my father, you just see my mom, we just kneel down like that and do like this. My father said, Say, Daddy, come here and let me kiss you. My father said, I don't want to kiss. Say, my husband, my this. My dad. And my father said, just put your hands in the pocket and take whatever you want. And she survived it for 30-something years before the man went to leave the law. They fight a lot. But when it comes to that area, you can't take that man. There was a woman who was always following my father home from the church. Very beautiful yellow woman. And my mom, too, is beautiful. And she's jealous. But this one, only God knew where she came from. She was always following my father home. Anytime
whenever my father wants to eat, that is when she will appear. You see, you ladies are supposed to be sensitive, but especially when it comes to the food of your husband. I'm teaching you today, I'm not talking to myself alone. If you don't take care of your husband, strange women will come and take them away. Strange women, Bathsheba, Jezebel, Delilah. The woman will just come in and sit with my father, and you know my father. I just discovered that it is nature that I eat. The woman will now wash her hand and be eating in the same bowl with my father. My father says, he's evangelist in me. First day, the following week, the same thing. Another day, the same thing. My mother said, my jewel will be put out. That day, she did, my mother sat. As the woman said, we have prepared your own. You are not eating from here. That was the last time she came. You have to be sensitive. Some of us are not challenged when it comes to that area. Think about yourself. If nobody has not done this to you, big offense, do this. You are angry with your husband, you are angry with your wife, and because I'm expecting. Go and look at those who are fighting on a daily basis. Sit down and ask, at least I've counseled some people. The cause of the fight is irrelevant. Go and look at it. Do you still love this woman? Yes. But why don't you come? We are not compatible. In what area? After 5 years, after 7 years. God will help us in Jesus' name. I have to stop here.